Hi guys, welcome to another Divi theme video. This is Jamie from System22 and webdesignandtechtips.com. Well, this is a little follow-on from yesterday. Yesterday we showed you how to pop up a little section or any section you wanted to from any module you wanted to, which is great. The only trouble with this is you can't scroll it. So today we're going to show you how to pop up a gallery. I've got a little button at the bottom here. It's a long gallery. And as you can see, you can scroll down it all the way to the bottom there. Really easy to do. Great little feature to have on your site. So let's get started. To do this today, we've got to get some code from Elegant Themes that they've nice provided for us. Now, if you watched yesterday's video, you've already got this, so you can skip forward. For those that haven't, I'm going to go through it again. So you want to go to this page. Halfway down the page here, you're going to find some CSS. You want to copy the CSS from the word body there, all the way down to the closing tag at the bottom of the little gray box. Once you've copied it, go to your theme options, which you'll find in Divi, theme options. We're under the general tab. Right at the bottom, you'll see your custom CSS panel. You can also put this in the additional CSS. I've already got mine in there. Just put your cursor in there and paste that code in there. Once you've done that, make sure you save the changes till you've got a little green check mark. If we go back over here, and you'll find this URL down below the video, just down below the CSS code, we've got some JS code, some JavaScript right here. You want to copy that from the opening script tag to the closing script tag there. Make sure you get all of it. Again, copy it. This time, we'll go back to where we were, we'll roll up to the top. Instead of the general tab, we need to go to the integrations tab. Mine's already in there again. You want to add this code to the head of your blog. Just put your cursor in there and paste it in there. If you've got something in there, you can scoot it down. That's absolutely fine. And just put this on top, or you can put it on the bottom after whatever's there. By default, there'll be nothing there though. Once you're happy, save those changes. Make sure you got that check mark. Okay, great. Now to make something actually pop up, we need to use two little class names. If I go up a little bit on here, the content that we want to actually pop up needs to be called ELB content. And you can start with one. And if you've got a lot of content on your site, you can go to two and three. We demonstrated that yesterday. I'll be doing number four because I've already got three of these on the pages. And whatever you want to make it pop up with needs to have the class name of ELB button one. And I'll demonstrate this all for you. So let's do that. I'll enable a visual builder. Okay, let's go down. Firstly, let's create what we want to actually pop up, which is going to be a gallery with a lot of images in it. So I'm going to add a new section. This is what we're going to pop up. I'm going to make mine a regular section. And obviously you can put any content in here you want. I'm just doing a gallery for demo because it's quick to make. I'm going to roll down. I'm going to grab the gallery module. There it is. Let's grab the gallery images we want. And we'll pop them in there. Okay. I'm going to need to tell it to show the amount that we got there. I think that was 30. And in the elements, I don't really want to see the title and caption. And there's no reason for pagination because we're showing all of them. So we've got a big gallery here with 30 images in it. And we want to pop this up. Let's just give it a little title on the top. Now I put a little row in. And we'll put a little heading in there. Great, let's pop that in the middle. And I make it an H2. And I capitalize it. Let's make it semi-bold. Put it in the middle. And of course, we want it at the top of our little section here. So I'm going to grab the row. I'm just going to pop it up the top of our little gallery module. Perfect. So we want to make this section a pop-up. We've got to give it a class name. We do that in the section. If we go over here, it needs to be called et-lb-content-a-number. Now, I've already got four of these on this page. So I'm going to copy this. I'll go back here, go over to the advanced CSS IDs and classes. I'm going to put it in the class name there. Make sure you put it in the class name and not the ID. It will not work. I'm going to change that last number to a 5. Because as I say, I've got four of these already on the page. If I roll down a bit, not that one, not that one. This one's got one. I go in here. I think this is number one. Yep, number one. And I got 2 and 3 and the original gallery that you just saw below. Okay, and let's create something to pop it out with. And you can use any element you want. You can use a module, you can use a button, whatever you want to pop it up with. So I'll just add a new button up here. I'll just pop it under this round button. So I'm going to hit the little plus. There's the button. And I'll just say gallery. And I'll pop it in the middle. Design, alignment. Now I'm not going to give it a link. Not going to put a link in there or anything like that. All I'm going to do is go over to the advanced to CSS IDs and classes. And again, we want to use a class name. And if we look over here, we need to give it et-lb-btn-a-number. And that number has to correspond with the section that we want to pop up, which was number 5. So I'll paste that in there and change that to a 5. So it knows which section it needs to pop up. And that's all there is to it. Let's just save this. But if we pop this up now, you're not going to be able to scroll down the gallery. In fact, I'll show you. Let's just pop this up. We'll save draft. And we'll exit the Visual Builder. If I click on this now, it pops up that gallery for us. But we've got no way of scrolling down the page. We've got a little scroll here, but that's actually scrolling the site behind it. So that's not going to work. What we need to do, so I'll enable the Visual Builder again. And let's roll down. Let's go into this gallery now. And we'll give it a fixed height. You can do that over in design, sizing. Here's the height. I'm in the section. 100 VH, 100 viewable height. So that's going to give it a height of 100% of whatever screen you're looking at it on. But we want to hide any overflow and let it scroll. So I'm going to go down to visibility, vertical overflow. I'm going to change to scroll. And you'll see another little scroll bar appear here. Let's just scroll up and down. Let's save the changes now. Save the page changes. And exit the Visual Builder. Now when I pop it up, we've got that scroll bar and I can just put my cursor in the middle of it and scroll all the way down there. Just exactly what we want. Now you may want to add just a little bit of padding to the bottom so you can get all the way down. But apart from that, that's working fine. Now I've modified this code slightly. I've made my close button a blue color, which is going to stand out against the dark and also the light backgrounds that I've got going on some of my pop-ups here. When you initially put this code in, if we go back to the theme options, to the CSS, we look down here, we roll down a bit. It says color of the closing icon. I made mine blue. Initially, it'll be white. So if you've got a white background and you can't see that closing X, it's because it's white. You can put any color in there you want, hex color. I'll just turn it to red for want of any other color. Let's save the changes now. Now we'll go back here. We'll refresh. We'll pop it up. And we've got a red X there. So if you don't see it, the chances are it's white in that code there. And like I say, just scroll down. Mine's on line 25 here. Color of the closing icon. The only other thing that I actually did, I changed the top value from 0 to 110 pixels to accommodate my actual nav bar. So if I take that out and put 0 back in there, I want to make sure we save the changes again. Go back here and refresh. Now when I click on it, it actually covers my nav bar there. And I really didn't want that. So like I say, I put in 110 pixels just after where it says top there on line 5. That was the only other modifications I did. And that's not a bad thing to do. So there you go, guys. Like I say, it's a follow on from yesterday's where we had these three right here. We've now got a gallery that you can scroll down. And of course, you can pop them out into light boxes and do whatever you want to do with your gallery. Go back up to the top. Close it out. So I hope you've enjoyed this today and found it useful. Don't think I saw my gap at the top there. I think I need to refresh this page. That's better. Got my nav bar up there. If you have found it useful, please give it a thumbs up, ring the bell, comment, share, and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Don't forget, I'll put the URL for this code down the bottom. It is really, really simple and saves you adding a plugin to your site. So once again, this has been Jamie from System22 and WebDesignAndTechTips.com. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.